Hello everyone, welcome to my news video on my channel. And in this video I'm gonna do some basics in Dictators No Peace. Firstly, before this video starts, I wanna thank you very very much if you watched my video What Happens When You Finish Dictators No Peace. That video is almost at 10k views. Is the time that I'm making this video, so really thank you, double thanks to the people who liked and subscribed to me. And because that video did really well, I said that I wanna do some tutorials for the game Dictators No Peace. But guess who is recording this video the second time, because got a blue screen while I was recording the first. Maybe I'll put a photo of the screen right now, because I made a photo. And yeah, let's begin. Here, as you can see, we're in a game with Poland, and the very first thing that you must do when you start up a new game is to click on this icon and max out everything. This is gonna make you make more money for coins a second. Also, you can make money by shutting these planes down just by clicking them and destroying. Yeah, so we got through the basics of making money. Now, something that some people don't know and are getting confused with are friendly rebels. So those little guys here will help you when the country is not ruled by you, is not your colony. You can give them money to give them food, guns and financial aid. And this thing will make them, will give them strength points here, which will fight only the army of a nation, of a country. It will fight both its military, its own, and its colonial army if it has one. So, what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna make the first propaganda. Let me click on this because it's distracting me. Okay. So, as you can see here, my army is 0 with 0 with 0. So, what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna click colonize without anything, just the friendly rebels. However, this comes with a downside if you use them and if you don't use them. Yes. When you conquer a country, you can click again on that thing, on that icon that appears at them. And earning money by maxing this. They're not their countries where it's just one, because yeah, it would be super overpowered if you had 4 or 5 at every country. So okay, now if we look at our rebels, they're now enemy rebels. Not that plane, because I need money. And once in a time, these rebels are gonna make some strength points and will try to overthrow your country. How you can prevent that is that you gonna give strengthen up your local military in that colony. Usually a star is enough. So yeah, this local military will also prevent your country from being attacked by other powers. Let's say that Portugal wants to attack my colony with don't think that it is gonna be attacked with its whole army. Just a little bit of its army is gonna attack here. This my colonial army will deal them, will annihilate them if they're more powerful than them. If a country manages to another country to overthrow conquer your country, it's theirs. If the friendly Yeah, they were friendly rebels. The enemy rebels manage. It's gonna be independent. But the rebels are gonna be again friendly, so you can reuse them. So I have only other, like, two things to show you. That to prove you that the friendly rebels fight only turn. So I'm gonna go here at my Air Force and make it half a star. And now, just with a star from the friendly rebels, I'm gonna attack Mongolia. My forces arrived. The army should arrive. It arrives slower because it's carried by the navy. See, and I won. Again, we max our things. And you can upgrade only things that are available. You can upgrade. Yeah, I no longer have money. But in this, solution comes in the trade deal good types. Many people don't know what's this. You got some comments on my video. What happens when you finish the game? I even explained to a guy. But I'm gonna show this in this video. So what does it say? This country's market, Brazil. We go to Brazil. If you don't really know the countries on the globe, I recommend you go on Google Earth, search it, and then come back. Yes, and I'm gonna go to its port here. At you, it's not gonna be Brazil. It's gonna be another country, but it's the same thing. Yes, and if, yes, it's T, in the message is T, yes. So I must purchase T at 10 coins. You can upgrade the size of your ship to carry more for a certain amount of coins, but I'm not gonna do that for this video. Also, you will not buy everything because you don't have the money. You can stay and just click here to make and farm, but I'm not gonna do that for this video because I'm recording here now and I'm not staying here. So, if we look in our message again, and then says after we purchase to go to the to India to sell it at 100 gold. So we go to India. Again, if you do not know the countries on the globe, this game may not be the best for you. Yes, we click here. And now, we don't remain on buy, we click on sell. And now at T, we are gonna sell all. And as you can see, we made profit. After that, this money you can use them at whatever you want. For example, I can make my army 1.5 star. And yeah. So, that's it for this video. We learned what friendly rebels do, how to make money, and the trade deal good times. In the next video, I'm gonna explain what the nuke does. And how to use them properly. Like, don't use it on a small country, but we are already getting into the next video. So the next video is not gonna be a tutorial. It is gonna be a challenge. Is and I have put a poll in the corner. It will be once restoring Yugoslavia as Serbia, secondly restoring the Ottoman Empire as Turkey, or restoring the Russian Empire as Russia. In the game, yeah, if you do not play as the country, it is gonna be, and I'm gonna be getting the model from the game. I'm gonna be, like, I know it was Finland, Latvia, Estonia, Belarus, Ukraine, Moldova, but it was the USSR. You can say it was Bessarabia. It was these countries, but I do not know if any. No. They are not owned by Turkey, which, yes, is the Ottoman Empire. They own the other things. Yes, so I'm gonna go and look. And yeah, choose. If this video goes well, I'm gonna make the another tutorial. But firstly, let's do the challenge. So, without any further ado, I'm gonna end this video right here. And bye-bye.